especially our elderly. If we look at, especially in this area, people have been isolated because of the GPs closing down. Public transport is not the way it should be, so people are more isolated. So one thing we would do as a party would invest in public services, invest in our National Health Service so people can be looked after, and of course bring back TV licences and make sure everyone in our community is looked after. But you're right, we need to start looking after everyone, especially our elderly people who have been neglected.
Well, governments of various hues have attempted to address this, but they've failed. So there have been reports, the Dilmot report was the last one, and in 2010 there was a consensus built between Labour, Liberal Democrats and Conservative, but then it was scuppered by, I think, my understanding, by the Conservative opposition at that time. It's an issue that can only be taken forward through consensus, because rather like we all say that the NHS shouldn't be a political football, neither should social care and the care of the elderly, because they go hand in hand, they're now under the same Department of State, and there needs to be a proper, accepted and consensual understanding that we need to look after our elderly, we need to finance it properly, and there's all costings available on each of the manifestos. We need to finance it properly, and we need to stop arguing about it politically and come to a consensus of how we deal with it as a society. Thank you.
Yeah, there are two realistic options. The first one is a really nasty one, which is you rely on pure luck as to whether your elderly relative gets dementia and needs years of care, and you end up with huge bills and bankrupt. That's the American way, and we're increasingly drifting in that kind of direction with our society. It's not the way I think we should go. I think the way we should go is to treat care in exactly the way we treat the NHS. But we've got to be realistic. We have to pay for that. At the current moment, inheritance tax kicks in at £900,000 if there's two of you who own a home. We have to be realistic at that sort of level, and we have to be realistic also about income tax. If we're going to properly look after all in our society, we have to be able to pay for it, and then those public services have to be held to account.
So this situation is not just UK. It's a modern Western world issue. We have an aging population. People getting older and not enough young people there to help support them. In Japan, we actually adopt children at the age of 30 to help look after the elderly. And so the thing we think we need to do is to try and address the aging population, try and get more young people to come to our country and help work, support, but also invest in the social care that we're lacking. From where I live across the road, new residential houses have been built for the over 65s, but it's, I think, maybe four or five, not many, and it's something we need to look at. Building these big retirement homes, I think, it's a term. Time homes for people to live in and use, because that gives you the nice social element that is missing. My aunt used to live in one, and my great-grandma, before they both passed away, they used to live in these ones, and they had a much better life than living in a flat on their own. So I think we need to just invest into social care, help look after the elderly, but we need to pay for it. I think the way to do that is to get more young people to this country to keep working and supporting the economy. All right, thank you, Jim.
So, I think for the Conservative Party, the last election, this social care issue didn't go down well. But what was revealing for me was actually when a kind of bold proposal was put forward, it came under sustained attack in the media. And it really was a shame that the debate didn't move on. And then one of the things that the last Parliament could have achieved, because the hung Parliament was, we managed to get through Brexit, to have had a proper debate on social care. And we've committed in this manifesto to have a cross-party discussion, debate and agreement, because I think that is the only way to bring it on. Since I became MP in 2010, there are now 1 million more people in the United Kingdom who are over 80. This challenge of ageing, I mean, it's a fantastic problem to have. Fantastic problem to have, but we have to address it. We have to look at innovative solutions. I've worked hard to campaign for Castleberg here to stay open. We need to look at our local resource, but we are also doing some amazing things in this area. I walked down Pateley Ridge High Street the other week and I met a lady that moved from Surrey to be with her family, thinking she was going to go back, and she stayed. And she stayed because in Pateley Ridge they've got a buddying system for older people in the community. Almost everybody has somebody who can go and do their shopping and go and help them and go and make sure that they're being looked out for. We're doing some great stuff here. We do need to look at a proper social care policy across party. Thank you.
Does anybody have any questions they wanted to ask in result of those? Yes.
How do we do that when the NHS and social care go hand in hand, and as government, you're saying we're privatising off our NHS?
So on how can we deliver on social care when NHS and social care are hand in hand, and the allegation made was the government was selling the NHS. I think there is private sector involvement in the NHS, as you know. When you look at the percentage profile, under Labour it was something like 6%, under us it's 7%, or you know, vice versa. We're not selling the NHS. The NHS is free at the point of delivery. We're investing historic levels of funding. We clearly need to do more. It is a huge, because of ageing, because of treatment development, we need more and more resources. But the NHS is free at the point of delivery. Under Conservative government will never, ever be anything but that. I think the social care issue, that you're right, is integrated, but the issue there is principally around people's homes, how it's paid for, and how we address that. And it's that debate around how do you fund it, what are the mechanisms to fund it, that I think do require a level of debate that goes beyond any one particular government or any one particular parliament.
Thank you. Andrew, to respond to that.
Can we just say that these issues of public services, as a doctor, I saw that the reason GPs and nurses were leaving the profession is because they were they love seeing patients. That's what they were there for. But they were involving so much time in doing unnecessary bureaucracy. It's exactly the same for teachers, and it's exactly the same for social care. What we have currently is a top-down government that tells us what to do. What we have to have is a bottom-up government that looks at the people that are involved in these processes, ask them how it works best, and then introduce that throughout and provide a model which is the best functioning model for all these services. That's what we need to do.
Thank you all.